What we can see here is that the debugger caught inside the plot points callback function, which gets called after our data gets loaded, that represents our attendance data for all the games. And just as a sanity check, if we use the console.table function to display the first 10 rows of our data set, we can see here that it looks the same, even though some of the columns are smushed, but we have a game ID, attendance, team 1, team 2, goals, tie, and so forth. So it appears that our data is loaded correctly. Stepping once more through to the key function, if we inspect what D is, we can see here that it's game ID 1, which represents the first game, Italy versus the US, and so forth with all the other data of our first row. If we call the getUTCFullYear function on our date object, we can see here that it returns correctly 1934. Stepping through to our rollup function, we can see here that leaves represents an array. And here we can see there's an array of 17 objects. If we inspect each of these, we can see that it is one game, in this case from the tournament in 1934. And the second one is another game from the year 1934. So what gets passed to the rollup is one group at a time of the grouping specified in the key function. And it is the job of the rollup function to distill, in this case, the 17 objects or games into a single value or a single aggregate. Going back to our editor to fix up our rollup aggregate function, we need three things from each of these groups. The first of which is the sum of all the game's attendances for a given year. The second is the longitude of where to draw this circle on our map. And the third is the latitude of where to draw this. To get the sum of the attendances, we'll be using the D3 sum method, which takes both some array or list-like object, in our case, leaves, and an accessor function that defines what to actually sum